described in captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
New Dimension Questar presents Adaptive Function of Form, The Beauty of Ugly.
The finger-like tentacles on its snout to grab a worm.
And as we discover the amazing ways these creatures make their way in the world, we can see that each one has a beauty all its own.
Ridges of flesh line a bat's face around its tiny, beady eyes.
Before we meet more uglies, we need to define beauty.
A baby laughs.
Human babies have features that nature has effectively programmed us to find beautiful.
Sitting on the floor, the mother lovingly tickles her baby.
These lovely saucer eyes, little snub nose, and tiny chin all help to make us want to protect and love our children when they need us most.
The blue-eyed baby grins.
That's a clue to why we find creatures like California sea otters so cute.
2 dozen furry, whiskered otters float on their backs in calm ocean water as if relaxing on sofas. One rolls over, holding its round face above the surface.
The big head and eyes, the little chin, and that innocent expression. We can't help but respond to them as we would to a child.
The otters huddle in the water. One presses its paws together as if praying.
But we're a lot harder on animals that don't conform to our ideal of physical perfection.
An otter dives underwater.
Take the peculiar snout we're hoping to unearth in the woods of Pennsylvania.
2 men hike through a green forest.
Dr. Ken Catania studies a mole with a face that's unique in the whole animal kingdom.
Oh, yeah, there's a tunnel here for sure. I bet he's tracking in there. Let's
see. Ken pushes sticks into the ground.
What we do, put 3 in here, make sure that he can't get through.
Okay. These sticks become bars that block the tunnel. If a stick moves, they've got something.
Okay, here he comes.
A stick wiggles, and the muddy soil trembles.
All right, go. I get him. Right there.
Ken's colleague digs out a tiny mammal.
Let's see what we got in there.
Looks like we've got a star-nosed mole.
Fantastic. Won't need the gloves for this guy.
Okay, here you go.
Really small teeth.
There it is, the extraordinary star-nosed mole. Just 4 to 5 inches long. A little bundle of digging energy. And one of the strangest noses in nature.
2 dozen wriggling, finger-like appendages ring the mole's snout, like light beams emanating from a star. Ken puts the mole into a plastic container on a scale.
Ken's catching moles as part of his research.
Let's see how much this guy weighs. 50 grams. So he's a big male.
His studies are revealing extraordinary information about how these moles use their noses.
Okay, there we go. Let's let him go back into his little burrow here.
They release the mole into a hole in the ground.
What is that strange star all about?
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.